Good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight. We begin with a case in Richfield that was treated by police as an attempted abduction of two crossing guard students.
But the Richfield Police Department raised several questions in their reports about why school administrators didn't have the same urgency. Lou Ragus joins us now with more on today's top story. Lou?
Well, Lauren and Julie, this happened outside the Richfield STEM Elementary School on March 21st. And according to police reports, officers didn't start investigating until 2 days later, when the dad of one of the kids called them upset because, in his words, the school wasn't doing anything.
At 2 o'clock, class is dismissed at Richfield STEM Elementary, and student crossing guards help people across the street safely. But on Monday, March 21st, two crossing guards feared for their own safety, according to a police report, after the girls say an older man stopped his car, offered them ice cream to get into his car, then began yelling at them when they backed away. This is a still of the surveillance footage showing the car pulling up to the intersection where the crossing guards were. The police report notes that in checking call history at the school, no staff members attempted to contact RPD to make police aware of the incident immediately following or the day after the incident.
At the moment that I was notified, police were notified.
Principal Amy Winter says she did call the non-emergency police number as soon as she learned about the incident, but she says she wasn't told right away. The police report says the girls immediately told the supervisor in charge of the crossing guards. He told police, quote, the students looked very shaken up, yet he didn't process that something really happened until later in the day. Police got a search warrant for the school's surveillance video, but didn't receive it until 2 weeks later. Even so, they found who they believe was the driver. He denied anything happened, and he was not charged. The student's father told police, quote, no one from the school was doing anything about it. Principal Winter says she talked with crossing guards and the girls' families, but did not send a note to all parents.
Is this something that you think other families who go here would be interested to know that this happened?
I know that that's definitely a conversation that's being had around making changes moving forward around that.
And after our interview this afternoon, Principal Winter did send an email to all parents and said that they regret not notifying families in a timely manner.
Well, what about the incident itself, Lou, and the man who was involved? They found him and he said...
Yeah, a couple things. I actually talked to him this afternoon. He said that he didn't say anything to the students, but he also said that he never talked to police, and that's pretty well detailed in the reports. Another thing, police sent his information and the photo of his car to neighboring agencies so they could all be on the lookout for any potential suspicious activity.
All right. Thank you, Lou. Mm-hmm.